In this video, we're going to go through some of the equations that help characterize that of rigid body motion. And this falls under fluid statics typically, which is kind of confusing to use the word fluid statics and motion in the same sentence. But when we take a look at what rigid body motion implies, you'll understand why it falls under fluid statics. We have this container that has a fluid in it. And if we go back to our general equation of motion, this was developed for both fluids at rest and fluids in motion, with the only condition being that there's no shearing stresses occurring in the fluid. So we could take this and break it into the individual components for rectangular coordinates, and they look like the following. If we do this for the x coordinate, we get the partial derivative of the pressure with respect to x equal to the density times the acceleration in the x direction. And we could do the same for the y direction. And lastly, for the z direction, we have this term with the specific weight, our gravity term, and I'm going to bring it to the other side so that we can lump these two together. I want you to think of a time where you have a container filled with a liquid and we quickly accelerate it in a certain direction. What's going to happen? Well, we know from experience that that slope of the fluid all of a sudden changes. Maybe we would get something that looks like this, and we'd have the fluid move. Now, of course, this is under a constant acceleration. As soon as you start changing the acceleration, maybe you get some sloshing around of our fluid. So let's take this open container of a liquid and move it at a constant acceleration. And when we do that, we get the following slope of our fluid. And we want to characterize what's going on. Let me draw a coordinate system for our fluid. We'll say that this is the z direction. We'll call this the y direction, and we'll call that end of the page our x direction. So we're moving this container in the y direction, and it's affecting our slope of our fluid. So it's having an effect in both the y and the z direction, but not having an effect in the x direction. So we'll say that ax is equal to 0. So if ax is equal to 0, then this means that our pressure gradient in the x direction has no change. So I'm going to rewrite our pressure gradient in terms of a positive value. This is just equal to negative rho times the acceleration in the y direction. And then when I rewrite this to have a similar form, dp dz, I'll set it equal to negative rho times the combination of acceleration due to gravity and any acceleration that we might apply to it in the z direction. Let's take a zoom in at our free surface of the fluid. So when we think about this slope of our fluid, we have a differential y with respect to differential z. So say we wanted to take a look at the change in pressure between two points, maybe here and here. At this first point, we have yz, and at the second point, we have y plus dy, z plus dz. So our change in pressure, or differential pressure, can be rewritten as the following. Our differential change in pressure with respect to y times our change in y plus our differential pressure with respect to z times our change in z. If you recall a few seconds ago, we had relationships for these differentials. Here we have dp dy, here we have dp dz. So we're going to go ahead and plug those in and rewrite this differential pressure. So here's the nice thing about this. Now, along isobaric lines, or lines of constant pressure, dp is equal to 0. So where are our lines of constant pressure? Well, at the free surface here, the pressure everywhere at the free surface is just atmospheric. So along a line of constant pressure, we know dp is equal to 0. So now we have this relationship that we could rewrite into the following form. I'm just going to pull over the terms so that it looks like the following. In the first form, we could cancel out the densities. We get the following relationship. So as long as the acceleration in the y direction is not 0, the free surface of the fluid will be inclined. It will have a slope that's based on the ratio of these accelerations. What does this mean? It means if we look at the free surface, when this container is accelerated with some constant acceleration in the y direction, the slope of that line is just going to be the acceleration in the y direction over gravity plus az. So if there's no acceleration in the vertical direction, in this case, the z direction, then it's just the acceleration in the y direction over g. Now another special case is if the acceleration in the y direction is zero, then what we get is that dp dz is not the hydrostatic pressure. It's going to be a function of the acceleration in the z direction. Now if there is no acceleration, then we could just get density times gravity, which is what we would expect when we calculate hydrostatic pressure. So this is saying that for a container that's falling or moving upwards, that the pressure gradient is going to be a function of both gravity and that acceleration in the z direction. So think about what happens when we have a freely falling film and the acceleration in the z direction is negative g. That's basically saying that the pressure gradient is zero in all three directions. This means that if the pressure surrounding the mass, the fluid here, is zero, then the pressure throughout the fluid would be zero if it's in free fall. Hence why when you look at a fluid in space, the only thing holding it together is the surface tension of the fluid. And one thing I want to show you is a simulation on the Wolfram demonstration site. And on this site, there's a number of simulations, but one that's pretty useful in this regard is one called pressure within an accelerating container. You could play around with what direction you want the container to accelerate, and you could see how it affects the free surface of the fluid. You could also change the density of the fluid. What that's going to affect, as you can see in the screen, is the gauge pressure. The gauge pressure is being reported for this red dot. So what happens when we just move the acceleration? Well, the gauge pressure is going to change. It's going to be more drastic towards the outside edges of the container because the fluid level at this point with respect to that dot changes more drastically than it does in the center. So it gives you an idea on how the pressure can change anywhere inside of the fluid when we have our container being accelerated in that horizontal direction. Hopefully that gives you a good idea of what we mean by rigid body motion.